On today's episode, the most important application for 3D printing, conformal cooling. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. A great deal of engineering is about making things that are hot. Whether you're injection molding plastics or building hypersonic aircraft, designing things that generate a lot of heat is a common element in multiple industries. Now, unfortunately, most materials used to make these things are less than optimally heat resistant. In a jet engine, for example, efficiency is everything, and the most efficient engines, as all first-year engineering students learn, operate with the highest delta T between combustion temperature and ambient. To make the perfect jet engine, engineers need materials that can withstand temperatures that will melt conventional alloys, something which was known as far back as World War II, when German jet engine designers developed a clever workaround to avoid using high-temperature superalloys called film cooling. For exotic applications like jets, ceramic matrix composites are a popular material, but making your parts out of expensive, heat-resistant materials is just one way to solve the problem. The other is active cooling, usually by pumping a cooling media underneath a hot surface to carry away damaging heat. Now, this has been standard practice for automotive engines for well over a century, and with the switch to electric vehicles, circulating liquid coolants, pumps, and heat exchangers, well, they're still important technologies. The traditional challenge for design engineers, however, is that it's very difficult to engineer cooling passages that are consistently just below the surface of hot parts that have complex shapes. For relatively simple shapes like jet engine turbine blades, investment casting of hollow sections and laser drilling, well, that gets the job done, but at very high cost. Now, at the other complexity and cost extreme, look at plastic injection molding. Now, that's a surprisingly difficult problem, with the competing needs for high-capacity cooling to reduce machine cycle times and consistent cooling to avoid warpage in the finished parts. And mold cavities can be extremely complex, making it impossible to machine cooling channels and injection molds that conform to the part shape. Until now. With 3D printing, it's possible to design and build cooling passages that are not only consistently close to the surface of a mold cavity, but they can be optimized for coolant flow volume and velocity at different points in the mold. Now, designing cooling strategies for injection molds is a very complex problem, and they're heavily simulated in the design phase, as is the flow path of the semi-solid resin that goes into the cavities themselves. Now, in a different way, the plastics industry has a problem as difficult as the turbofan engine community. Margins for injection molded commodity plastic parts are incredibly small, and the cycle times for injection molding machines can make the difference between profit and loss on a job. Seconds matter very much in the plastics industry, and the ability to quickly manufacture large quantities of complex parts with minimal distortion is what separates the big league players from the amateurs. When you pick up that knife and fork at KFC, take a close look at it. That's a very high volume, low margin injection molded product, and they're remarkably consistent in form. Complex conformal cooling is going to allow faster machines running at higher temperatures with lower unit costs for everything from coffee cups to rocket engines. Now, space satellites are cool, but technologies that can make the injection molding preforms for blow-molded soda bottles faster and better, well, that's where the action is, if you ask me. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. For our deeper engineering video series for the manufacturing professional, visit engineering.com TV to watch exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, not found here on our YouTube channel. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching.